I want to say this with all seriousness, that too many of us have not taken our culture as being a very important part of our identity, and we haven't passed it on to our children effectively. When our children were young, in fact, my husband was speaking English to him. I was the one who was teaching them in Yoruba, although probably making a lot of mistakes those days, because it's part of who they are. And it is important that, you know, we teach our children to be proud of their identity. Because if they go to the US or to the UK to live and so on, they must not forget their roots. They must not forget who they are. And so we always encourage culture here in the school. We encourage it in our home. That even if I go to the U.S. now, my husband and I go to the U.S. and we see our son at the airport, he will greet us properly as a Yoruba man, not as just holding out his hand. And this is something that, you know, when children don't know their language, they don't know their culture, you are depriving them of something very, very important, which should belong to them. And so I always encourage parents. I've seen children that come from a home where the mother is Yoruba, the father is Yoruba, and a child cannot even say Ekaro, does not even know how to kneel down or prostrate. And it's to me, it is sad because, you know, they just see that as, oh, that is African culture. But when you now have children who know who they are, and then, you know, it's always amusing to me that when my children and their friends get together, they want to speak in Yoruba, and I'm pleased. I'm very happy. Inumidu. Ah. Tori, omo Nigeria loa. So it is important that we do not deprive them of their roots, and that when, you know, even the Bible says, train up a child in the way they should go, and when they are old, they will not depart from it. Even in terms of culture, not only in godliness, which of course is very, very important, but also in culture, that train them in the way that one has been brought up. I mean, now my husband is always very, very happy when he gets on the phone and he is saying, ah, Tokumbo Baoni, and that one will be speaking back to him, Dada Nimsa. And you know, they're very happy because then they can speak. And I will always tease my husband that he's reaping where I have sown, because he wasn't the one who really taught them. But I do pay a lot along. Thus far, God has helped us.